point 'em out, 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 watch 'em panic. Got two chains on, I'm too late. Got one watch on my wrist. I'm round, round and I'm getting it. I'm young, but I ain't ignorant. They keep asking who the hell you think you are. Him, 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 him and him. They keep asking who the hell you think you is. Him, 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 him and him.
Been the best in this game for a minute. If I want it, then I'ma go get it. Ain't no asking, you know I'ma spin it. I don't go back and forth like it's tennis. I'm in mode, I'm in line.
It's week 5 of the NFL. And coming up, we'll see Justin Jefferson. He was an absolute force out there a week ago, torching defenders in a historic performance. It's the Vikings and the Packers, and it comes your way next.
This place first opened way back in 1957. We are inside legendary Lambeau Field here in Green Bay. Today we've got a Week 5 matchup in store here, as it'll be the Minnesota Vikings taking on the Green Bay Packers. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we look at this Packer team as we enter play here. They come in feeling good after back-to-back victories.
And the offense last week, they had things humming. If you're a defensive player, you may get over.
So here's the Viking offense making their way out. And trotting out there, their tall quarterback, standing at 6'5".
Remember when we were kids and they all said, hey, whatever you want to do, make your kid a left-handed pitcher, make him play baseball, they'll play forever. Forget that. I want a quarterback, all right? That's what I want to raise. In this era where you throw it around like crazy, you put up numbers like he did in his last game.
Last week, almost 500 yards. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
Offense.
So not a lineman, but the tight end instead this time, drawing the holding call.
And more what you're getting with tight ends are guys who are much more receiver than blocker. They may be willing, but that might not be their thing. Oftentimes, they'll be the ones getting the penalties.
And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. They get 14 yards, but not enough for the first down due to the previous penalty. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and 3. Going right back to Akers. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us, need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give him the yardage that they needed, but they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
They'll run on first down with Akers. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. These two teams, you may remember, they met in Minnesota earlier in the year with the Vikings coming out victorious. So a victory here in Lambeau would give them a sweep of the season series. From the 41, here's second down and 8. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. That is incomplete. He was trying to find Justin Jefferson there, but now it'll be third down. And look at this Packers defense. They come into this one ranked number 17, so just starting the bottom half of the league against the pass.
And those are the kind of plays that this unit needs to make, because they know that going against a team of this magnitude and the way that they're playing, they cannot afford to let them get out of roll early. Chip away their timing.
17 yards, first down, Vikings. So opening drive, third down, they complete the slant to move the sticks.
And ordinarily, it's a high percentage pass when you throw it. And receivers like to run that route because it gets the ball in their hands pretty quickly. Just a couple of quick steps upfield, break towards the middle, and the ball should be there. And then they can get to do some work afterwards.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. From the shotgun, here's a give to Akers. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
This defense for the Packers, they were excellent last week in the win over the Chargers.
And what I saw on film was a nearly unstoppable pass rush. 5 sacks last week, plenty of hurries given up. So now what do you do on offense? You just max protect, keep everyone in and run the ball, or maybe just one or two receiver routes in order to try and keep your quarterback upright.
Second and 5. And he's got this to Jefferson. And they move this all the way down to the 9. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
A lot of precision being shown on this opening drive. They've been methodical. They've been crisp. And as a reward, they're going to be set up with an early first and goal.
They'll run here with Akers. And he gets halfway home from the 10 to the 5 on a pickup of 5.
Hat tip to that offensive line. They're clearing some holes, even down here deep in the red zone. And that's a nice pickup on the ground on first and goal.
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. Again, it'll be Akers. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Minnesota. Cam Akers, his 8th rushing touchdown on the year. And the Vikings have taken the early lead on the road here at Lambeau. And that caps off what was really a balanced opening drive for them, Charles. They work in the rushing game and the aerial attack, and they end it with a touchdown.
Strong in so many ways, wasn't it, partner? Their ability to throw it and run it and accomplish their goal, they've got to like the way that they started this ball game.
The Vikings taking the field here for their second drive of the game. And they are trying to create some separation within the division. And look, CD, I know that this is still the first half of the season, but this is a big matchup no matter where it falls, because these are the top two teams right now in that division.
And if you can build a bit of a cushion as you head towards the second part of the season, that allows you to survive the expected injuries, potential upset losses, all of those things, and still be in good shape.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and 5. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
And the same pass is knocked down by those guys that call the frustrating fullbacks, the linebackers. You know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
They'll look to throw here. Now the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. DeMarcus Lawrence in there for the sack, and it's an important one from a personal standpoint, as that is sack number 100 in what has certainly been a terrific career to this point. Well, last game he had 2 sacks, got another one here, picked up right where he left off.
Brandon, he spent the entire offseason working on new moves, new techniques, trying to add to his arsenal of pass rush moves. Certainly paying dividends in what we've seen so far.
That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived, as they've now given up 2 straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they get this game tied up.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw.
That's down the field for Jefferson.
They got his man complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. That one good for 37 yards. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now back to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
And this is taken in at the 5. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. They'll look to throw again. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Right up to that point, I was about to say, he's had a pretty good half catch in the football, but let's just be honest about it. He should have caught that.
And he knows that. That was one right in his breadbasket and one he normally catches.
Here's a run with Akers on second down. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota.
Cam Akers. His second touchdown of the game and his 9th on the year. And the Vikings are an extra point away from drawing level. So his strong first half continues as he finds the end zone here for the second time.
And definitely good blocking at the point of attack. And you just have to love watching the way he can create space down near the goal line. And he's able to take it into the end zone.
The Vikings going to take over now late in this first half. And with good starting field position and 3 timeouts as well in their pocket, no reason not to try and put a late scoring drive together. Let's go.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
And they're not going to go quietly into this halftime break. They know they're in for a fight, so they're trying to make every possession count. They took the big shot there, but it winds up incomplete.
And 2nd and 10, he'll look to throw again. Escaping the pressure right. The improv act there, good for 9, and now they'll be looking at a 3rd and short, 3rd and 1. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime.
He's got his target. That's complete.
He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. But forget the run on 3rd and 1. They shock the D and rip off a pretty big play. Well, there's your leading receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, putting on another clinic well over 100 yards.
Are we taking notes? We should be, right? Because I'm going to go back and watch this tape and really enjoy what I'm seeing. The route running, competing for the football, just breaking down in defense.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
And a 2nd down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
To throw again. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
converted one time thus far in this game, so you can see the frustration starting to come out a little bit. Third downs, they've been a problem for them all game. They've got to start becoming solutions.
It's the Vikings' turn on offense. We get ready for their first possession of the second half. And Charles, it feels like we're set up for a good second half here. Came out of the locker room, one score game. Now the lead has already changed hands. Well, this offense, they've got an opportunity right now to take that lead right back.
Yeah, and it feels like you're going back and forth almost a little bit like a tennis match, right? And we're just there, you know, our heads just keep moving. Which side has it? Which side's going to score? How are they going to go out doing it? A little bit of a challenge for each side trying to match each other.
On first down, they'll stay with Akers on the ground. And able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Now a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 32-yard line. A gain there of 21 yards. And that last reception puts him over 150 yards now on the game, Charles.
And now it's not just execution. It's not just performance. It's a mental aspect that's going on. Because right now, he has kept the defense so much on their heels, got them looking at each other. Who's going to cover this guy, and what type of coverage can we put out there to try and slow him down?
They'll run out of the gun with Akers. And he's going to take this one down to the 25. 78 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon. Here's second and three. They'll set up to throw, eluding the pressure right. And it's caught in the end zone for the Viking touchdown by Justin Jefferson. A great play there. His 11th touchdown of the year. And the Vikings have retaken a third quarter lead.
So a very strong first drive in the second half, Charles, as they've turned that halftime deficit into a third quarter lead.
And they were pretty purposeful there, weren't they? Measured in their approach. But boy, they executed awfully well moving the ball down the field.
Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field.
And they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one.
And a throwing here to start the drive as they connect left side. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me. I'm going to keep firing.
And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. On play action, they'll throw. This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown. Justin Jefferson with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Vikings answer back with a touchdown of their own to take a fourth quarter lead. Might be seeing that one on the highlight shows tonight. The home run ball here in the fourth quarter to take the lead.
There's nothing like being aggressive, preaching that to your team, and then following through all the way through. Go ahead and throw one more up there. Why not?
Been a great game, and we are not done yet.
So here are the Vikings to take over. They're working on a four-game winning streak, and they lead this one as well right now as they start first and 10.
Let's go.
They'll give this to Akers running right. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. That good for 22 and a first down.
It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
Well, you know me, partner, I never tell them to back off of being aggressive, but sometimes you see the consequences when you're overly aggressive and you don't secure tackles. Guys, break through.
Trying to sell out to pry that football loose, and just as you said, cost some yardage.
Yeah, you gotta go get him. Stand him up first before you go for the ball. Don't just go for it initially.
It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
All of a sudden, those lanes that were there earlier in the drive dry up near the goal line. That's a good job defensively to diagnose the run and stop it for a very short pickup.
Flood. And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Vikings are able to build on to their fourth quarter lead. We talk so often about how hard it is to win in the NFL when you turn the ball over. And here a late turnover leads to a fourth quarter touchdown and a 2-score lead.
And what's more important is being able to take advantage when a turnover presents itself. You've got to come up with points to make the other guy pay. They're able to do so here, and they've got a pretty good chance now of winning this football game.
Minnesota now ready for their next possession. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. We've got to have two hands on the football here as they run on first down. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Now it looks like he'll throw here. Sliding out of the pocket. Powers. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. A 21-yard touchdown run. And the Vikings are well on their way to a 5-0 start as they extend their lead.
That's a really good decision right there outside of the pocket. You've got to know the right time to shift from passer to runner. He was looking and looking, nothing there. You can almost feel the brainwaves firing as he calculates, I think I can win a race to the pylon. And he turns out to be right. Touchdown.
Today, if you like points, a lot of them went on the board. Both offenses were clicking. Charles's defenses, meanwhile, have a little something to clean up before their next contest.
Yeah, neither end zone had a stop sign in it, did they? I mean, for both sides, visit it, and with frequency. Not fun to be a defensive player, but on the offensive side of the ball, those guys had a blast. One team came away with a victory, even better for them.
So for Minnesota, they improved to 5-0 now on the young season. And they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for the Packers, the loss will move them back to 3-2 on the year. And perhaps fortunately for them, they'll get an early bye next week and come back to action in week 7.
Look, look, yeah,
full court press or full blitz, we going all out. It don't matter any time of day, I came to ball out. We TCG, never duck a smoker, any call out. Better be ready to go to war until we fall out. 0 to 60 like Ludacris, we came to roll out. You know I gotta get my check, so please don't make me hold out. Bust down Cuba in the summer day, I make it cold out. They was hot then, now they cold now. Left wrist dripping, I got it froze now. Went from rags to riches, take the clothes now. My name heavy all across the globe now. We ain't playing HBCU, I strike up the band. Stomping on them like a cute dog or alpha man. In Miami, hard rock jumping like a rock band. You know me, I love my green and tees like a Packers fan. I'm a player, gotta keep it player, how the game go. With the steppers, I ain't gotta tell them, they just train to go. Calling plays and I'm calling shots like the head coach. First class, so we take the private, we don't do coach. They was hot then, now they cold now. They was hot then, now they cold now. They was hot then, now they cold now.
Dirty, yeah, you know we global with it. Black fit, limo tint, you don't know who in it. Whole team having motion, world no winning. I'm known for handling, been in the other dudes known for dissing. Big motion, boy, big vibing, boy. Tell them pop that laptop down, cause they ain't making noise. Yeah, homie, we them boys, who they be preaching about. If you see MT around, we're all about to make a crowd.
Never leave the house without the pack. Where my cat? Take an L and try to double back. We ain't doing that. Say she mad, but I know it's cap. I've been through with that. Need someone to hype me up. Hype me up. Need someone to hype me up. Hype me up. Hype me up. Need someone to hype me up. Hype me up. Hype me up. Need someone to hype me up. Hype me up. Hype me up.